Een cadeautje uitzoeken voor je baas is altijd lastig.
I would,
Laat staan als het de president van Amerika is.
Is it difficult to please?
No, I don't think so. No, no, I mean...
So what would you get him?
I'm looking. If you're buying something for the president, you better be careful, right?
Een ochtend op pad met de Amerikaanse ambassadeur Pete Hoekstra. We praten over hoe het is als conservatieve Amerikaan in Nederland.
You are against abortion, right?
Yes.
And you are in favor of gun possession.
Yes.
Over het Amerika van Trump.
You have an America that's super divided at the moment.
It was super divided under President Obama.
En natuurlijk zijn omstreden opmerkingen over Nederland.
You know, it's something that it happened. And I've learned from it.
Piet Hoekstra werkt bijna een half jaar op de gloednieuwe ambassade in Den Haag. Terug bij zijn Nederlandse roots.
Hola, Mr. Hoekstra.
Hi. Goeiedag.
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 You speak Dutch?
Klein beetje.
Klein beetje.
Ik ken wel een klein beetje Nederlands.
Is het nou Piet of Peter?
Piet.
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 But you were born as Peter.
Yeah, I was born as Cornelis.
So how did it end up being Piet?
You come to America, and they say, Cornelis, and they say, why haven't the name need in America?
Yeah.
What's his middle name? Piet. Peter.
Piet is 3 als zijn vader en moeder besluiten het Nederland van de jaren 50 achter zich te laten.
The Netherlands was still struggling to recover from the effects of World War II. The war in Indonesia, and so they said, we're going to America, opportunity for our kids, a sense of adventure.
But this, so they were economic immigrants.
Economic immigrants, yes.
Piet groeit op als Amerikaan met politieke ambities. In 1992 wint hij een zetel in het Huis van Afgevaardigden. Een conservatieve republikein in hart en nieren. Tegen abortus, tegen het homohuwelijk en voor wapenbezit.
Can you imagine that we find it a bit bizarre sometimes that you have then, you know, these issues on schools with the shootings? You know what you know about Holland and your Dutch roots.
Yeah.
Do you understand that?
In my short time here, I have discovered that for me to try to characterize or describe Dutch behavior are very dangerous places for me to tread.
Het is duidelijk dat Hoekstra inmiddels wel uitkijkt wat hij zegt.
We have a duck, an orange duck waiting for
yes.
you, so I think we should get going.
Alelik Eentje.
Let's go.
In zijn nieuwe rol als ambassadeur wil Hoekstra vooral praten over de goede verhoudingen tussen Nederland en Amerika. Zijn baas is minder diplomatiek.
The European Union is possibly as bad as China, just smaller. Okay? It's terrible what they do to us.
Volgens Hoekstra heeft die toon een functie.
As the Dutch would say, sometimes we maybe need to be blunt in how we talk to our friends.
Well, blunt you are.
Blunt we are.
Yeah, but the
Dutch pride themselves on being blunt themselves.
Yeah, but this is, people here find it more, well, I can't speak, of course, for everyone, but it's not just blunt, it's dividing, and it's very aggressive.
The president feels very, very strongly that we need to be prepared to respond to the military threats and the economic threats that the world faces today. And so we do need to have this blunt conversation with our friends. And it's not to make divisions. It is to make us stronger.
We wanted to take you to get some herring.
I thought that was a really bad idea.
Why?
I'm not real fond of herring, but I love drop. So
drop.
So wij gaan naar de dropwinkel.
So, zoet of zoute drop?
Zoet.
Zoet.
Zoute drop krijg je nou high blood pressure. Goeiedag.
Goeiedag.
Oh yeah.
Een zakje zoete drop en nu nog een cadeautje voor Trump. Hij kent de president anderhalf jaar door zijn hulp bij de verkiezingscampagne.
What would you get him?
I would...
This!
Yeah, I think I would pass
knowing
on
Donald
that.
Trump yes. and his remarks?
No. Then I would probably do this. I probably would go with Stroop Waffles.
I think it's a very safe choice.
I think Stroop Waffles would be a very safe choice. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So, off to the beach.
Off to the beach.
Perfect. Well, let's start with the drop.
Yeah. Take it somewhere.
We have, just like the president, a red button.
Yeah. His button is bigger.
Well, why do you think it's bigger?
Because
everything around Trump is big.
No, bigger things happen if he pushes it.
That is
which
true.
Will not happen, but.
No?
No. No.
Do you understand that people are seriously worried with Trump in office?
No. No.
You don't understand?
No. Not at all.
Take what just happened with the children and immigration.
Which is a policy that's been going on for years that Donald Trump did not start.
But separating the children from their parents and putting them in cages?
They were not being, no, let's not exaggerate here. So the separation of parents and children has been, my understanding, is something that's been going on and was being done under the Obama administration as well. This is not a Donald Trump policy.
Do you ever question him or you just...
No, I mean, of course, but you know, you also take a look at immigration and say, this is an issue that is not, migration is not only an issue that we're concerned about and need to be concerned about in the United States. The EU, of which the Netherlands is a part, is turning away ships and putting them back into the Mediterranean. Rather than, you know, for the Dutch to be judging the Americans, it is the recognition that migration and migration flows is a serious issue that Europe and the United States have to deal with.
Afgelopen januari begint Hoekstra aan zijn nieuwe baan. Een maand voor zijn komst confronteert Nieuwsuur hem met deze uitspraak.
Chaos in the Netherlands, there are cars being burned, there are politicians that are being burned.
Vervolgens ontkent hij het ooit gezegd te hebben en er ontstaat een rel.
I think we both can conclude that you didn't have the best start here in Holland, right?
No.
How do you look back at that?
Disappointing. I mean, who wants to start that way? But that happens.
And I mean, do you understand why it caused so much uproar?
It's something that it happened, and I've learned from it.
What did you learn?
I've just learned from it.
Do you understand why it caused so much uproar? I mean,
I don't talk about it anymore. Okay, it happened, and.
But do you find it annoying when I ask about it?
You can ask. You can ask, but I don't have to answer the question. It has nothing to do with, you know, American foreign policy. I'm not revisiting. That time.
Period.
Period, yeah.
Off to the beach?
Off to the beach.
I can't believe why your parents left. Look at this.
We couldn't believe it either.
No?
Well, I didn't come back until the late 70s.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then the question that you do ask is you come home and say, wow, it's beautiful. Why would you have left?
Maar Amerika blijft thuis. Hoe lang hij in Nederland zit hangt af van Trump, in wie hij ondanks alle kritiek heilig gelooft.
You can say America is divided on some things about Donald Trump, but at the same time, people are working, wages are going up, the economy is growing. And so, you know, these are the kinds of results that, bottom line, people are looking for.
8,000 kilometers from here.
Yes.
That's where home is.
Yeah.
I mean, you're now here for 5.5 months.
Yep.
Often when you take a distance from your own country, you look at it in a different way. Do you now look at your country in a different way, being here?
Looking at America from far away, I'm still very proud of who America is and what we stand for, and at the same time have an appreciation for, you know, that the Dutch believe that they have a great country, and we respect their views as well.
You're a true diplomat.
I don't know about that, but we keep learning.
You became one. You became
we keep learning, and we just kind of every day hope that we can do our job a little bit better than the day before.